Hey everybody, and welcome to another StuKent Expert Session. Today, we'll be hearing from Shubham Goel. You might recognize Shubham because he was recently on the hit Netflix show, The Circle. Before that, he ran for governor of California as the youngest candidate in 2018. He is a proud UCLA graduate and is currently working as a co-founder for a software enterprise company. He hopes to continue more TV and film work. We are all ears, Shubham. Take it away.
My name is Shubham Goel, and today I'm going to be giving you an introduction to SQL4 marketing. I hope everyone is doing well, and I'm very excited to do this. A little bit about myself. I was actually, or still am, I'm on the Netflix show called The Circle. So if you need anything to binge, I highly, highly recommend The Circle. A premise to the show for The Circle, it's a group of strangers interacting only through a social media platform. And through that interaction, the group of strangers have to form bonds, alliances, and through that we rank each other, and one by one we vote through these ranks to eliminate each other. The show touches a lot about social media relationships. You can be anyone you want to be in The Circle, so you can be a catfish, you can be yourself 100%, you can tweak certain stuff here or there. So I think it is, if not the show that is most representative of the world we live in today. So I highly recommend, if you need anything to binge, please watch The Circle on Netflix. It's a great show, and I'm not just biased because I'm in it. Great cast, great story. A little bit about myself. I have a software enterprise company where I am a co-founder of, where we build enterprise and restaurant software for companies like restaurants, enterprises, care facilities. So across the state in California, we have various clients where they're using our software. So if your organization needs any type of software, please reach out to me via LinkedIn or my social media. My LinkedIn is the same as my name, Shubham Goel, which is on the left side. We do all types of stuff. So we have restaurant software, we have business software, we do payroll, time management, check-in, check-out. We help with compliances, our software, and we have analytics. So our software is really great. So if anyone needs any help, please reach out to me. I'm also on social media. You can reach out to me on Instagram or TikTok. My socials are on the left, Shubham_Goel with two L's at the end of Goel. If you like comedy or content, I think I have pretty good content. Please reach out to me. And message me on LinkedIn or Instagram with any questions, connecting. That'd be amazing. All right, on to our next slide. Okay, what is SQL? Essentially, companies have things called databases, and databases are basically sets of collection of data, right? So take, for example, this database I quickly built. We have three data pieces, three movies, Hunger Games, 1917, Ad Astra. If you haven't seen them, highly recommend them. Great movies. And here's the power of SQL. Say I was telling my boss, said, hey, Shubham, I want to know every movie in this database that has the genre drama. Well, because of the power of SQL, you can write just a couple of lines of query code, SQL code, and you can find that data point. SQL essentially is the programming language that is the bridge from you to your data sets, databases, so that you can see your data and manipulate it, edit it. So with SQL, you can edit data, you can delete data, you can add data, you can join data, which is such a powerful thing, because now the questions that you're asking about your data, you can quickly get with a sec of SQL. And what I think is one of the coolest things about SQL is you don't need to be a complex programmer. You don't need to know Python or JavaScript or C++. SQL, at the power of your finger, you can learn how to write SQL very quickly. And all of a sudden, you're able to make these big queries with your data and see what's going on. And it just makes it just offers a lot of powerful tools. And I think the learning curve for SQL is very easy. It's much easier than I think people think it is. So I highly recommend to do it. Say, for example, another SQL example with this database is, say I want to say, give me a list of every movie that is not, that does not have, I don't know, say George MacKay in it. Even though, side note, George killed the 1917 role. He was amazing. But just for the sake of example, let's say I want to say, hey, pull me all the movies where George did not star in it. With SQL, you can quickly write that and you can get the answer. And that's the power of it. It's just so powerful. It's so easy. Highly recommend SQL. Great. The next thing we're going to touch about. SQL and marketing has become very imbued over the past few years. So a brief overview. Marketing companies, marketing agencies, anyone on the marketing team, you can definitely have a feeling with the tide of how the industry is going, where you are using data more and more than ever. Because think about the name of the game. With marketing, you're essentially putting out campaigns there and you want to know what's working and what isn't working, right? With SQL, those questions you're asking, right? Because essentially what happens a lot of time is marketing will do campaigns, and in addition to the Google Analytics dashboard you have or whatever software dashboard you have, there's questions you want to know. So if you're in a big company or a bigger scaled one, you're going to talk to marketing is going to meet with the data team or the engineer team, and you're going to want to know the answers to your questions. But if you learn SQL with marketing, you can get the answers to your own questions and the answers to your own campaigns, how they did, what do I need to tweak? And essentially, you become so powerful in the sense that you're operating not just on one end, you're operating in the whole thing, which I think is such a powerful tool, which is why I continuously recommend it. Here's an image of a megaphone, right? Because with marketing, you're trying to market great products to people all across the world. And a lot of times you're just putting all different types of campaigns, fishing rods, and seeing what's catching and what's working. With SQL, you can write queries and you can figure out which of your campaigns are working and which aren't working, looking at the data points. And it's the same thing as the 90-10 rule, right? With the 90-10 rule, it's essentially saying that a lot of times 10% of what you're putting out there is like 90% of your revenue. So through a data perspective, you should be focusing on that 10% versus the 90%. With that data, you'll be able to see like what is working and what isn't working. Like I'll give you an example, right? For my company, what we're doing is we have a lot of customers. We're based in California, right? So we have a lot of customers in different areas, a part of California. And based on how much the customer acquisition cost is, I wanted to see if there was a relationship between customer acquisition cost, the time they signed up with us, and the region. And because of we have all the data points, we have it collected, simple SQL, I can pull that all up for me and my team, and we can find answers to that. Another thing is we can look at, say, someone was like, hey, Sally, if your name's Sally, or hey, X, whatever your name is. Hey, Sally, give me the revenue for all the months where we were over $30,000. With SQL, I don't have to write a huge essay of codes. I don't have to put algorithms. I don't have to write a function. I can write simple SQL, just a few lines, and I can get the answer to you by the time you have your cup of coffee. That's how powerful SQL is. And in terms of strategy, I think for me with my professional experience is I always said the less questions and less people you need to depend on to get the answers you need or to the less questions you need to ask, I think the more powerful you become. And with SQL, it's the same thing. So definitely, I highly recommend it. Use SQL. And it's so simple, guys. It really is like, you're going to learn it so quickly like that. You're going to be like, why didn't I learn it easier? And so definitely use SQL, because next time you use the megaphone, it won't just be lightning bolts that are coming out. It's going to be like thunder blizzards coming out, because it's just much more powerful. So highly recommend it. I'll plug back. I think I touched on it, but my Instagram and TikTok, Shubham_Goel. If you guys want to follow, hit me a follow, connect. If you have any connections, if you have any questions, please reach out to me or anyone a part of the Stukent team. So thank you so much. And let's go to the next slide. Okay, Here's my advice for you if you want to learn SQL. I will give you a quick introduction to just basic SQL. So in the center of this image, we have SQL. And the three building blocks of it are the select, from, and where. These are three building blocks to it that are so easy to be able to be implemented. So select is essentially the part of the query, and a query is what you use in SQL to get a data point. Select is the point of the column or thing you want to pull, right? From the whole data table. From is the data group that you're pulling from, and then where is the criteria itself. Like say where I want to, so say I want to be like, okay, I want to select the names of all the contestants of the circle. So I would say select names. And then let's see. And then from, I would be like, select the names from the circle data set, right? Because the circle table or whatever, where the contestants are ages 24 or older. So I would do where age is greater than 24. And that's a simple query. I was able to pull that up just like that. So that's why I think it's so powerful. My advice for you is there's so many great resources online that you can just quickly see the format to SQL and the organization to it. So learn the structure, because the structure is very simple. The next thing I would ask you is just start coming up. If you work at a company or organization, think of the data you guys work with, because that's the data you're most familiar with. Think about questions you want to know the answers to regarding your data, and then just try writing queries to it using SQL. Learn the structure, and the structure is very simple to use. Learn the terms, which shouldn't take so long, and then just start writing queries for yourself, trying to figure out the answers. And then you can look, also another thing I would say is look at examples online so you can see questions people ask for queries and the answers, so you get the rhythm of it. Then just start asking yourself queries you want to solve for your own company, and just keep going more complicated and complicated, and all of a sudden you're going to be like an SQL wizard. And I'm going to be like, damn, you're better at SQL than I am. And another great thing about just touching back, if you don't work right for a company, another thing you can do is just look at examples and any data that you can come up with. Maybe just write, you know, another thing I would do is maybe just make a data point of, make a data table yourself, a table of stuff you like movies you like, food you like, different columns for each of them to differentiate them. And then just start asking questions about that table and just writing queries here, there, and seeing how to collect that data. If you want to edit, add, delete data, join tables together, figure out it. Just ask yourself questions and answer it. And that's the quickest way I would say. Just get your hands-on experience with there, and you're going to be an SQL champion in no time. So on to the next slide. Okay, the future. We live in a world where big data is becoming more and more important. More companies than ever are collecting data about all of us. In many instances, actually, what companies are doing now is they are taking aggregate data about each individual. So they take data about you from one source, and then they collect it from either themselves, another point of data for you, or another company, and they're combining this data. So data is becoming a huge commodity for these companies, and you're seeing that it's, for a lot of companies, their data is actually their assets now. In many cases, it is for most. So I think we're going towards a big data trend. So if you can learn SQL, you're going to be much more well-versed for what the future is going to be, and you can take advantage of it, and you're going to be in that top 10% of the curve. Data is becoming more and more prevalent. SQL is going to be much more valuable. So here's a picture of one of my favorite movies, Back to the Future. You got Marty McFly in his DeLorean, and he has a suit on. He has a jacket and a sick hat because he wants to acclimate. He wants to get used to the future and blend in. Same thing as Marty. If you learn SQL, you're not only going to blend into the future, you're going to kill the future. You're going to be great in it. So I highly, highly recommend that you learn SQL very quickly, and because it's powerful, and it's a lot easier than you think. So just to recap the video as a whole, I think marketing and SQL, it's becoming much more prevalent. If you look at, I was looking at LinkedIn jobs earlier this year, just because I was curious about if SQL and marketing is everywhere. And I was looking at a lot of them. SQL is embedded everywhere in marketing, right? Because I think the hiring managers see the power of it. So if you do that, you're going to have a step up against your competition and you're going to be able to help a lot. So definitely take advantage of that trend, work on it. If you have any clients that need restaurant software or business software, please reach out to me. I'm in California, of course, where we're situated. Please reach out to me on LinkedIn. If you like comedy content, please reach out to me on my socials. I hope you all are doing well. I wish you all the best of luck and love. And please remember, if you need something to binge, if you need a good binge, I highly recommend The Circle. All the love to y'all. Pew!